क्वेश्चन नंबर 26 सेज अ लाइट वेव ऑफ फ्रीक्वेंसी म्यू एंड वेवलेंथ लैम्डा एंटर्स अ लिक्विड ऑफ रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स 4/3. द वेव ट्रैवल्स इन द लिक्विड विद फ्रीक्वेंसी म्यू एंड वेवलेंथ 3/4 लैम्डा, फ्रीक्वेंसी म्यू एंड वेवलेंथ 4 लैम्डा/3, फ्रीक्वेंसी म्यू एंड वेवलेंथ लैम्डा, फ्रीक्वेंसी 4 μ/3 एंड वेवलेंथ लैम्डा. नाउ डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज द लाइट वेव ट्रैवल्स फ्रॉम वन मीडियम टू अनदर, द फ्रीक्वेंसी रिमेन्स अनचेंज्ड. So the final wave would have the same frequency as well. The final wavelength can be written to be equal to λ/μ, where mu is the refractive index of the medium, which is given to be equal to 4/3. Therefore, the final wavelength comes out to be equal to 3λ/4. And hence, dear students, the correct answer for this particular question should be option number 1. Now, let us proceed to the question number 27. Question number 27 says that the ratio of resolving powers of an optical microscope for two wavelengths λ1 is equal to 4500 angstroms and λ2 is equal to 600 nanometers is. Now dear students, the resolving power of an optical telescope is inversely proportional to the wavelength of the light used, which means that the resolving power 1 by resolving power 2 can be written to be equal to λ2/λ1. Herein, let us assume that λ2 is equal to 600 nanometers and λ1 is equal to 4500 angstrom, which can also be written to be equal to 450 nanometers. Substituting the values, we can write that Rp1 by Rp2, that is the ratio of resolving powers, is equal to 600 by 450, which will be equal to 4/3. Therefore, the correct answer for this particular question should be option number 3. Now dear students, let us proceed further to the question number 28. Question number 28 says that a beam of light of wavelength 400 nanometer from a distant source falls on a single slit 2 millimeter wide and the resulting diffraction pattern is observed on the screen 2 meters away. The distance between the first dark fringe on either side of the central fringe is. Now dear students, the distance between the dark fringes on either side of the central fringe is actually the fringe width of central maxima. Which is equal to 2λ D/d, where lambda is the wavelength, capital D is the distance of the screen from the slit and D is the width of the slit. Now we have to find out the value of 2λ D/d. On substituting the values, we can write 2 multiplied by 400 into 10 raised to power minus 9, because 400 nanometers is the wavelength, multiplied by 2, which is the distance of the screen from the slit, divided by 2 into 10 raised to power minus 3, which is the slit width of the single slit in this diffraction pattern. Dear students, on solving it further, we get a value of 8 into 10 raised to power minus 4, which can also be written to be equal to 800 into 10 raised to power minus 6, which will be equal to 800 micrometers. And hence the correct answer for this particular question should be option number 4. Now dear students, let us proceed to question number 29. Question number 29 says that two Polaroids are crossed to each other. Now one of them is rotated to 30 degrees, the percentage of incident unpolarized light that transmits through the system will be. Now dear students, initially let this be the axis of first Polaroid. Now this would be the axis of second Polaroid. They are crossed to each other. Now the second Polaroid is rotated by 30 degrees. The final axis can be represented as follows. This is the axis of the first Polaroid. And this will be the axis of the second Polaroid. Now, since it is rotated by an angle of 30 degrees, the final angle between the axis of these Polaroids will be 60 degrees. The final transmitted intensity can be written using the formula I0/2 cos² θ, where theta is the angle between the axis of the Polaroids. Herein, theta is given to be equal to 60 degrees. So, therefore, we can write I0/2 cos² 60, which turns out to be equal to I naught by 8. Now, dear students, we have to find out the percentage of incident unpolarized light that is transmitted. Therefore, we have to find out the transmitted intensity by incident intensity into 100. That is 100 by 8. Now, dear students, this will be equal to 12.5%. And hence the correct answer for this question would be option number 3. Now, dear students, let us proceed to the next question, which is question number 30. Dear students, question number 30 says that the synthetic material used for preparation of Polaroids should possess the property of first option, anomalous thermal expansion, second option, dichroism, third option, high elasticity, or fourth option, both 1 and 2. Dear students, the materials which are used for the preparation of Polaroids must possess the property of dichroism. That is option number 2. This is the correct answer. Dichroism is a property by which certain crystals allow certain polarization or the polarization in certain direction to pass through them, whereas they absorb the polarization in other directions which are not along the pass axis of those crystals. This allows the Polaroids to allow only certain directions of the polarizations of the light to pass through them and hence act as a polarizer. Now, dear students, let us proceed to the question number 31,